This video is going to be about the quadratic formula. And the quadratic formula is a formula you can use if you've got a quadratic equation and you can't solve it by any of the other methods that you know. So let's look at an example. Here I've got the equation 2x squared minus 3x minus 9 equals x squared. So the first thing we do, if we want to solve this, is get all of the terms on one side of the equation. So I'm going to subtract x squared from both sides. And that'll leave me with x squared minus 3x minus 9 equals 0. Okay, now you could try to solve this. Actually, let's do that. Let's see if we can just solve this one of the ways we know. So since I've got an x squared, I'll just put an x here and an x here. I know I've got a negative sign over here for my third term. So I'm looking for two factors of 9, one positive and one negative. And when I add them together, I want to get a negative 3. Well, the only ways I can factor 9 would be 1 times 9. And the difference between 1 and 9 is not negative 3 or 3. And the other way would be a negative 3 and a positive 3. But I can't, the difference between negative, the sum of negative 3 and positive 3 is just 0. So that's not going to work. Okay, so it seems like I can't factor this, but like I said, you can always use the quadratic formula, and that will solve things. So here's the way we do it. First, we make sure the equation is in what's called standard form. So standard form means that your exponents are in descending order. I've got an x squared, and then x to the first, and then I've just got a constant. And all my terms are on one side of the equation, and I've got a zero on the other side. The next thing to do is look at your coefficients. Well, I've got this x squared, which means the coefficient is 1. And now we're going to assign a letter to each coefficient. In other words, I'm going to say that the first coefficient, the 1, is my a, and negative 3 is my b, and negative 9 is my c. So I'll write those over here. So a equals 1, b equals negative 3, and c equals negative 9. Now we're going to write the quadratic formula, which you want to make sure you've got memorized. Okay, so the quadratic formula is x equals negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac, and that's over 2a. And now what we're going to do is take these values, the a, b, and c values, and plug them in where I have an a or a b or a c in the quadratic formula. So I'll get x equals negative, b is negative 3, negative negative 3, plus or minus the square root of negative 3 squared minus 4 times a, which is 1, times c, which is negative 9, and that's all going to be divided by 2a, and a is 1. And now the only thing left to do is just do the math for all of this. Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't put the, I want a 3 here. Okay, so here we go. X equals negative negative 3 is a positive 3, plus or minus the square root of negative 3 squared is 9, minus 4 times 1. Minus 4 times 1 is negative 4. Negative 4 times negative 9 is positive 36. And this is going to be over 2. Okay, now before I run out of room, I'll continue over here. So the next step is I want to combine this 9 and the 36. So now I've got that x equals 3 plus or minus 9 plus 36 is 45. And that's over 2. And now I've just got to factor, I've got to simplify the 45, the square root of 45. 45 is not a perfect square, but 45 is 9 times 5, and 9 is a perfect square. So let's see. X equals 3 plus or minus the square root of 9 times 5 over 2. Taking the square root of 9, that's 3. So x equals 3 plus or minus 3 times the square root of 5 over 2. So this is my solution to that original equation. Let me go back over the steps. Take the original equation. We put it into standard form, which means we're going to get all of the terms on the left side or on one side of the equation. It doesn't matter which side. And the other side of the equation will equal 0. Then write down your quadratic formula. Make sure you've got it memorized. We take each of the coefficients, and the first coefficient, the x squared coefficient, we call one, we call A. The x coefficient we call B, and the coefficient for the constant we call C. So we've got an A, a B, and a C, and we've got a quadratic formula. And now all you have to do is plug the values that you've got, the A, B, and C values, into the quadratic formula, and then do all the math, and here we are. You're going to get a solution. So none of the individual steps is hard in this. This is true of a lot of math. Basically, this process is made up of a bunch of very simple steps, but you've got to have the process memorized, and you've got to be very careful as you go through each step not to make a careless mistake. Okay, I want to do another example, but there's not going to be time in this video, so I'll come back with another one. See you soon.